1, 2, 3, action. Okay, what is up guys? Farhan here with Zah once again, and here we have Hidayat. Hello brother, how are you?
Brother.
Nice to meet you.
Good.
And I actually reached out to Hidayat on Carousel to request a review on his bike because he's selling it. I just want to thank you lah bro, seriously. This bike, when I was in secondary school, me and my friends were always talking about this bike. Want to buy this bike lah when you go up or something like that lah. Oh. But it was all a kid's dream. I think for you, Zah, you're
all the... During my time, I think it's the RD350. Yamaha RD350.
Another legend. But to me, this bike is already a legend. RVF 400, like in those days, in the 90s. Quite legendary also. So maybe this will help Hidayat sell the bike. Yeah, but I just want to ask you, so are you going to miss it when you sell this bike, bro?
Definitely, bro. I'm really going to love this bike so much. Miss it.
Means a lot to you,
lah. Means a lot to me.
But hopefully the new owner will be in good hands,
Yeah.
So before we ask Hidayat about his experience with the RVF 400, we're gonna give a background about it, So manufactured from 1994 to 1996, the Honda RVF 400 sports bike was one of the legendary bikes on Singaporean roads during the 90s. The RVF 400 is known for its legendary V4 four-stroke engine, and was known for its fantastic handling capabilities. So the engine is the legendary 399cc 4-stroke liquid-cooled V4 configured with a carburetor fuel system and a sequential 6-speed manual transmission. So in Singapore, there are currently so few examples left given the state's strict vehicle control laws. However, during the 90s, the RVF 400 has attained a reputation and a cult status amongst riders. Okay, so Hidayat, I want to ask you, let's face it, this is a 90s era bike.
And
I'm sure it lacks the technology that current bikes have to offer lah, such as fuel injection, ABS, etc. So what made you want to get a RVF in, you know, this current era when there are so many bikes out there with better technology lah?
It's like what you said, during secondary school you want to, you have a dream about this bike. So I want to live up that dream, because previously my brother used this bike also when I was secondary school. So I tumpang him everywhere he go. So I know the power of this bike compared to the other bike like Super 4. I mean the previous bike CBR 400 Fireblade. Compared to this bike and the Fireblade bike, the pickup of this bike is much more power than that bike. And for like Super 4 bike, you can see Super 4 bike has the good exhaust system, good sound, good everything. But the top speed that you can go is RVF can beat the Super 4 lah.
Because it's a sports bike.
Sports bike.
But Super 4, there's so many irritations. Irritations, you know, like over the years, they released several other generations. And then those generations, they evolve with the technology. You know? But not this bike.
Okay, such technology is like that Super 4, they got power cut. I think got power cut, Super 4. I think like reach 120 power cut or 140, I'm not sure. For this bike, you can whack the bike.
You can whack the
like,
bike.
Like a two-stroke bike, like TZM bike, like SP bike, you can whack. It's like the rider ride you, not the you ride the rider.
Okay, I understand.
Between this bike, this RVF 400 and the CBR 400, how different are they in terms of engine-wise or power or performance?
Okay, like what I said, power-wise, I think I prefer RVF. Like the pickup, everything. So for the design part, CBR is like more square. CBR 400 is more square. This one is like more shape. I think it doesn't much different lah between these two bikes.
This bike is quite old, as you know, and it has been through many hands.
So
you have only for me 2 years, is it?
Yeah, 2 years plus.
2 years plus. So that time when you bought it, how much is it?
How much the cost?
How much?
I think like around 11k
plus. 11k
plus
guys for a 2A.
Yeah. Because I really love this bike compared to other 2A like R3. I prefer this bike. I want to live to my dream
I see.
At least for once in your lifetime,
yes,
you
correct.
Want to live your childhood dream.
Yes, correct. So as for my generation, I think I'm the youngest among you guys. So for my generation, they didn't talk about this RVF bike, old bikes like TZM bike.
Because they never grew up with those bikes.
I think they grew up to those bikes because of their brother. I think for now they like see this bike. This one what bike? I think what old bike? I think this one old bike confirm got problem one everything.
But during my time, this RVF, the Rich Abing, we love this bike. Rich Abing always ride this bike.
Yeah, I remember. I know. It's either the Fireblade or this bike. Or Repsol. What the SP.
If you have class 2A. Only those class 2B riders ride the SP.
Most SP riders will transit to RVF because they look familiar. But two headlight.
But SP last time all the abing like to mod like no tomorrow. So like, they make the exhaust damn loud. And then they like to rempit also and wear chacukang. Oh my god, those 90s were the craziest days, you know.
Yeah, for this bike, right, the exhaust is on the left side, so it's quite rare lah.
Yes. Yeah, quite rare. Yeah. Correct.
And this one is similar to SP bike because of the swing arm. Usually got another what?
Only got one
side.
Like the modern BMWs lah.
Throughout your ownership of this bike, how do you find its handling and performance?
The handling is quite I can say it's quite aggressive about the handling.
Mm-hmm.
But the cornerings are really solid because for the handling part, right, this bike need to go lower. It's a sports bike
Yeah, correct.
Obviously, compared to R3 is you can
a bit higher.
But this one is you need to lean forward a bit more. The cornering part is really perfect
You corner baring
or not? Kira
yeah. Compared to this bike and Super 4 bike. The center of gravity, this bike is much more higher. So this bike is much more lighter, I can say. Once you corner, right, then you like automatically can go more.
So you can corner baring
Can corner baring. But the one, I love this bike. I don't want to.
You don't want to this one
You don't want to.
You want to relax only.
Okay, I see. So this is your bike number.
Second bike.
Previously, what were you riding?
My bike was TZM.
Wow.
That one is another legendary bike, bro. That one is get to review.
You guys should review before this.
So TZM guys, if you are still riding TZM, TZR, if you have this machine under your ownership, under your name, come join us in our videos.
Yes.
Because we want to review that machine.
Yes. So I don't think you use this as a daily driver lah. This is like your weekend bike.
I can say.
Weekend bike. But do you think this practical as a daily driver? Because I know the abings in those days they use this bike every day.
Okay.
lucky those days don't have GrabFood, you know. They use this for GrabFood also.
I'll be surprised, bro.
Sometimes I use it for delivery food also.
Then is it really nimble in traffic? Like you want to selit or you want to
selit still can selit.
Like in heavy traffic.
Or the like maneuvering part is quite hard lah compared to the street bike.
Because it's very low, right?
Yeah, very low. And you got less turning also.
So the turning radius is lesser.
Yes.
So you cannot really like do a crank course.
Crank course maneuver.
You cannot do a crank course.
But don't mind me asking, eh Johor, have you ever whacked the bike?
I got back in the bike in Johor.
Like how fast are you?
How fast? I think 240.
Wow. Okay. Okay lah.
Okay lah.
Sports bike.
Sports bike.
Of course lah.
Yes, bro. Seriously, man.
I got one race with my friends Super 4 friends. He can reach 120, then I can reach 240.
Then pickup wise, how is it? How fast is it?
It's quite slow. I think from reach to gear 3 it's quite aggressive The open valve, change the valve, everything.
Then the pickup, like how to say 0 to 60 roughly how much you think?
Didn't count actually.
You didn't count lah. For you quite fast the
for
pickup.
Okay. Just as Super 4.
Enough to escape like sticky situations. Like how to say you want to avoid certain things. Is it enough for you to like?
Okay, quite enough lah.
So far when you ride this bike, did you ever had an accident or fall or skidded or buang?
Oh, this bike I never skid before, but. Once a taxi driver hit me. He reversed his car. He didn't see me at the back, so he just.
I see.
But there's no damage lah.
There's no damage lah.
That's quite damage.
Okay lah.
I mean like a chip off of the paint. That's all lah.
But we did see some damage right here. It's from the previous owner like you mentioned.
The fairing here.
Because nowadays I cannot find the cover set for this bike, so it's very hard. Buy it at China.
Speaking of parts and sets and whatever, is it an issue for you for this bike right now?
So far it's no issue. I asked the mechanic can overhaul for me, can find the piston ring, everything. So this bike is quite familiar with Super 4 bike, so doesn't matter.
It's quite similar lah.
Only the exterior part very hard.
I see.
So engine wise, there's no problem lah.
There's
no problem in finding parts for the engine, but for cosmetic wise, accessories, definitely will be a very difficult issue lah.
How's the fuel consumption like for the RVF 400?
Oh, the fuel consumption is a bit, I can say it's a bit hard lah.
It's a bit on the higher side lah.
Yeah, on the higher side.
So full tank, how far can it bring you?
Okay, from Jurong to east side, I think like Bedok ah, like maybe 3 to 4 times journey or 4 to 5 times journey here to there.
Okay. Roughly around.
Roughly yeah.
Roughly lah. Roughly about what?
The only thing
Jurong
I can
Bedok is about 40. Yeah, yeah. 40 kilometers.
The only thing I can compare is with Super 4 ah. It's quite similar also.
I see. So full tank is how many liters?
I'm not sure about that. But
okay, so next owner, you just pump, then you see then you tell us in the comment below.
Usually normal lah, like maybe like I pump $98, $25, $30, $26 full tank.
So in your post you mentioned that this bike only takes in like high octane. It doesn't take the lower grade, is it?
Yeah, high octane. But can take 95 also lah.
And then don't forget, how about maintenance? What's your maintenance schedule like for the RVF 400?
Maintenance schedule like is like normal for any bikes.
Every 3,000 lah?
Yeah.
Then you change the oil, spark plug.
The air filter, spark plug.
Oh, so basically, engine oil, air filter, the oil filter?
I don't think I have.
Okay, nevermind. Later we'll find.
Okay. Apa lagi,
Don't forget about the coolant also lah.
Coolant.
So this bike is quite hot. Cool.
So far you haven't bring to track right?
Never bring to track. I really sayang this bike.
Sayang man, you really sayang this bike to the point where you don't even dare to bring it to track.
Ni, for the past 2 years you ride this bike, is there any major issues to the bike?
So far there's no major issues lah. So far. The only thing I do is only top overhaul, that's all lah.
I see.
Because of the mileage right, so
So it has been very good to you lah.
It's very good to me. Never break down at all.
Very reliable. Okay. So in your opinion, it's quite reliable.
Reliable.
Bike. I think bikes made back in the days, right? In the early days, 80s, 90s, even 60s, 70s are more robust. You know, last time I used to own a Vespa, and my Vespa was made in 97. You know, so its engine is very robust, and I really regret not taking out the engine when I send it for scrap.
He always tell me this story.
I wanted to, you know, if I were to take out that engine and send it to Malaysia, you know how much I get for one engine? RM3,000.
Wow.
RM3,000 for a Vespa engine, you know.
Okay. Just never review any Vespa bike.
Belum lagi.
Vespa. We hope if any riders will come up, then can.
Okay. Because nowadays, the old bikes, they got a rebate.
Because I think, you know what I think, old bikes are more, how to say, durable than now current bikes. Because they are just mechanically Spartan in nature.
Correct.
And then they lack the technology.
They lack the electronics. Electronics, yes.
So, that's why I feel that, how to say, certain things, if like, spoil just change that particular part lah. Nowadays, if you want to repair a bike, like, if one thing spoil, you have to change the whole thing. Because it's electronically linked.
Yeah. And certain bikes are like fully on electronics, you know. It can be an issue, you know, if you have weak battery on a transponder, right? Then suddenly your whole bike cannot start. How?
Yeah. Mean same goes to like car also, automatic car and manual car.
Hidayat, what kind of reaction you get from the public when you know you are riding around with the RVF 400?
Usually when I stop at every traffic light, people will see my bike. Then got uncle 40, 50 plus see my bike, then they give me a good review. Like, hey, very good bro, this bike, very old bike. That's what they say.
I think because they live through that generation. Yeah, they live through that, you know.
Yeah, they live through that. Yeah, same like us lah. We grew up, you know, looking at idolizing such bikes lah. Which is why Hidayat is riding his bike right now lah. Living his secondary school dream, you know. In your 2 years of ownership or maybe previous owner's experiences, has this bike been modified?
So far, I'm not sure because I'm not the second owner. Maybe got like previous, like maybe 10 owners.
Because this bike is made in 96. So
96,
that's like 20.
There's a lot of
hands that are through with bike.
Yeah, correct.
Sorry to say lah, bro.
Okay. I understand.
Ni kira apa, motor rolling. The pipe, the Yoshimahal.
Yoshimura, yes.
Yoshimura, because it's expensive, right? So it's Yoshimahal lah.
Yoshimahal.
Kau sial lah kau. And then are this screws original?
So I just bought last month.
You change lah?
Yeah, I change.
Okay, I see.
I mean everything is, can say it's not original lah. I don't know.
But it seems like it seems that the bodywork is intact. Most of the parts, generally the look is intact also.
So maybe a few cosmetic changes here and there.
Yeah.
So Bro Hidayat, what is the best memories you had with this bike?
Actually, whenever I ride this bike, it's really a good memory really. Because I really like taking pictures with this bike, go somewhere, like good views, take picture. Maybe like Chinatown can take.
So far you have been and above JB. You been right out to Melaka.
I went to Melaka.
Okay.
Take a good shot about for this bike. With my girlfriend.
I see.
Friends.
How does it feel, you know, to own a legendary 90s era bike?
Because you know? Most of my friends didn't ride a old bike because I mean they afraid to jaga the maintenance. But for me, I take the risk and really this bike is good to me and I'm good to him. Mm-hmm. So this really doesn't matter lah. It's about the servicing part, everything.
So you're kind of the like, how to say never mind lah, just go only lah.
Just go only lah, don't scared lah.
I have the, how to say, prestige of owning this RVF 400 lah.
Kira apa sacok apa
sacok. So Bro Hidayat, thank you so much, you know, for showing off this bike. So hopefully you, I don't know, are you rushing to sell the bike?
Actually I'm not rushing. But if somebody want to buy my bike, then can let it go lah.
Nice.
I see. How many people have viewed it already?
Maybe like more than 5 people.
More than 5 people lah.
But still no takers yet lah.
No takers. Because they got some consideration about this bike. I mean the maintenance part lah.
Then just tell them lah, the maintenance engine wise is robust. You know, don't have to worry. Parts is very easy to get. The engine component part lah, it's just the accessories, the cover set, that one is a bit difficult lah. So just sayang the bike, don't buang
the bike.
Okay lah, but if you do sell it what are you gonna say to the next owner?
Really, just say lah. Really, don't whack this bike. Really sayang this bike. Don't whack every day. Whack sometimes.
Yes, that's why it's his second bike. Okay, thanks Hidayat for showing off the bike. This is really a legendary bike, bro. Seriously, secondary school time, you know, I always admire this bike. I don't want Zah.
Well, I don't really admire this bike. For me, it's the TZM, you know.
TZM. Yes.
So, if you guys riders out there, if you own TZM, KR, RXZ, RD350 or RD250 or whatever bike, doesn't have to be new bike or old bike. As long as it has a nostalgic value, a sentimental value to you, and you want to share that experience to others, contact us.
Yes.
Join us. We want you to be in our video.
Yes, document your experiences here. And share it with others lah. Okay lah, so gonna finish this vlog here. And yes, we will see you in the next one.